Howdy folks, my name's Christian and welcome to Bullish on Farming. We got a beautiful, calm, serene morning here with the main group. Some of the calves are just starting to get up and stretch their legs. Probably had a feeding in the wee hours this morning, and now they're just relaxing, chewing cud. But I wanted to make a video just to show how docile our animals are and the benefits of working with your animals daily. Those of you who've seen some of the videos before, which at this point I think is like three people, you guys will know that we move our animals daily. We move our cattle on daily rotations. We do mob grazing. And well, the benefit of that is that these animals become very familiarized with humans. I mean, if a stranger came on the farm and tried to handle these cattle, they could, but they would be a little, their guards would be a little higher, but they know me. I run this herd. They know that I'm the gatekeeper to everything they love, that being fresh pasture, fresh water, new landscaping conditions, and they love it, and we love it. We love giving the animals everything we can that will serve their highest good. So their highest health, and that goes beyond just, you know, physical health, but the spirit of the animal, the emotional and mental conditions, okay? We honor the process that nature has designed for these animals, and we want to give them the best quality of life in that context, okay? We're not just trying to get these animals fat as quick as possible and not really caring for their quality of life. Folks, look at this. Does this look like we're just trying to raise fat animals in a low quality of life? No. This looks like a painting. I mean, your eyes just see the cows on the green, and something about that just screams health. Okay? And, well, that's just a consequence of holistic management. What we're doing here isn't rocket science, folks. It's what a lot of people were doing back in the day. When, you know, big ag hadn't kicked in as of yet, and people were producing in a mindful way of the ecology of the planet. And it didn't really serve people to damage their land, although, you know, the information and education on how some practices do deplete land wasn't as available or widespread then. There were still farmers who were connected to their farming processes and clearly observed what was more natural or beneficial to their animals and their land and what wasn't, right? You don't got to be a scientist to know that keeping animals moving onto new fresh conditions and allowing nature to recycle the impact of the animals is beneficial. That's how things grew. That was the growing cycle and process of animals and plants before humans had anything to do with it. Now, I'm not trying to get political here. I'm not trying to say that, you know, humans, you know, what we're doing is wrong or bad, but I'm just trying to insinuate that there's a mindfulness that we need to bring back into farming, and that many people are, that when we do, we'll completely revolutionize our entire agriculture production on this planet. Anyways, this isn't supposed to be a political channel. You know, I don't have a strong opinion on what you should be doing. At the end of the day, I'm just a guy who runs cattle, raises animals, and loves the land. Okay? And I want to thank you for coming here and watching these videos, because, you know, this really isn't for anything more than to share the beauty of what we're experiencing here every single day. Take a look at these calves. Some of them are not even 2 or 3 months old yet. I'm within 5 yards of them, and they're not spooked. They know who I am. They're still in a benign state. They don't got adrenaline running through their blood and in fight or flight. Folks, this is how we raise our animals. This is the quality of life that the animals get to live. Okay? And it's just an absolute joy to do this. This pasture was not the strongest pasture, and I knew that. So I brought out a bale of hay yesterday and spread it out. And they've left perfect residue. Some areas a little thick, that over there. And I'll come to this with a pitchfork, spread it a little thinner. Well, you know, we'll see, because I'll leave these cows in here probably for another couple hours, and they may have picked through that a little bit more. But take a look at this trampling here. This is what we're looking for, folks. A lot of fescue in this field's gone to head. We want to break that plant, drop that seed to the ground, integrate our seeding process with our grazing process, and give back to the land in ways that we know how to. Hey, Milky. You can see that these mums have slicked right off for the most part. Winter coats are gone. Some of them still have them hanging around. A lot of these mums looking clean, slick, and in great condition. For those of you who haven't seen previous channels, heard me mention, these are Angus. We got a couple crosses in here. Galloway cross and a Simmental cross. Look at these mums. Calves nursing. Looks like they're all starting to get up and start their day. Nothing like mother's milk. All right, well, thanks for joining this morning, guys, and we'll catch you on the next one.